Hey guys, this is Naveen here. Welcome back to Naveen Automation Labs. So guys, today we have one very interesting topic on Git workflow and branching. What do you mean by Git repositories? What do you mean by different commands? And what is the workflow of Git? And what do you mean by fetch? What do you mean by pull, push? How do you check out a branch? And the basic thing is you have to understand that what is the best practice to do a PR. PR means a pull request in the PR review process, and what is the difference between fetch and pull, and then what is the branching concept in Git. So a lot of things we have to understand. It's like slightly confusing topic, and most of the people, they do a lot of mistakes over there in terms of learning Git. So let's talk about it. So before I explain this particular diagram, I give you one basic workflow how exactly it works. So what we have do, let's see, for example, this is your two things actually. One thing is, I would say, not here like that. Let's see, like this. So this is the remote repository. Remote means remote repo that you have created, okay, on github.com, on your Git, okay, on the Git cloud, I would say. And you have created a particular copy over here, and there is a master branch and other feature branches are available over here like that. So what is a master branch, feature branch, I'll tell you in some time. But try to understand how exactly it works. And let's see, you are sitting over here, okay? You are working on a particular product and you're writing some code. It could be development code, automation code, or whatever, or it could be any kind of file. It's not about only Java code or Python code that you're writing. So let's say this is your Eclipse or any IDE that you are using it. For example, let's say I'm using Eclipse over here. Then this is called the working copy. Remember one thing. After that, what you have to do that you have to, okay, there is a stage is called a stage or index. You have to push your code from your working copy to stage index by using add command. So here you have to use git add command. Okay, I'll tell you what do you mean by stage and index in some time. And then after that, the next step is that is your local copy actually. This is your local repository actually, right? So this entire section that you are doing it over here, this is your local section. Local means that it's happening in my directory, in my local directory for this particular guy, and the guy name is, let's see, Naveen, right? Now, how will you push your code from stage to index? For that purpose, you have to use your git commit command, git commit minus m with some reason over here, you have to give that. And once this is done, you have to push your code to remote repository. Remote means now the code is available on the Git cloud. So this is called the remote part. And this is called the local part. And from there, you will put a Jenkins over here or any CI/CD pipeline you will create, and then you will publish your artifact somewhere on Nexus location or centralized repository or something like this. This is not Git. Okay, this is not part of the Git repository. The Git repository workflow ends over here. Okay, and starts over here. So whenever you're writing a code, you're writing something, you are doing something, and then you have to add the code to the stage or index. So stage or index is a kind of bucket over here, guys. And it maintains, this is just like a workbase. This is just like a working, not the working exactly directory. It maintains under .git folder, it maintains its own stage or index. This is just like a truck over here, let's see. In this particular truck, you load all the files over here and then you move it to the local repository. Now this entire truck is having, or this entire bucket is having all the files in it. Now it's ready to be pushed to the remote repository. So between local repository and the working directory, Git maintains one staging or index over here. Okay. Now what is the purpose? There are multiple purposes. From the stage index also, you can revert, you can do a rebase. From the local also, you can do a rebase, like hard rebase and soft rebase or something like this. So that's an advanced topic, we can talk about something later. And then from the local repository, once all these files are available over here, right, whatever the, you have already moved from working copy to stage and stage to local repository, right? And from here, you have to push the code to the remote repository. So this is a typical workflow. If someone is asking you at a time of interview, what is the Git workflow? So this is a typical workflow. This is stage number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Only 4 steps. The life cycle. Okay. These are the 4 components you have to design. Okay. Now let's talk about the branching concept over here. So this is a, that's why like I'm explaining this first, so that you can understand this entire diagram. How exactly the push, pull, and merging, cloning, okay, checkout, and PR will work. Then only you can understand that. Okay. So let me erase this particular thing. Okay. Now let's see this particular diagram. I have just reversed this diagram like this. Okay. In the 90 degree direction, the reverse mode. So this is the upper section is called the remote part. So this is the section number 1. And then after this horizontal line, this is my part number 2. Okay. So in the first part, you see that, okay, this is my remote repository somewhere on the github.com. And then I have master branches. And then I have different feature branch, feature 1, feature 2, feature 3 branch. And then we have sign up feature, let's see, add to cart and payment feature is available like that. Now, in the local side, now this is my local side. You can see the working directory for Naveen for the local. Okay, Naveen is the developer who is writing the code. And this guy is working on sign up feature or any feature, let's see. So let's assume that, okay, sign up feature is there. Naveen is having Eclipse ID or maybe any IntelliJ or VS Code or whatever, it doesn't matter. So I'm maintaining my working copy as well. So this is working copy means where exactly you make changes over here. So I would write, you make changes in your working copy. Remember one thing. So whatever the code that you're writing, you're always doing your working copy, which is available in your Eclipse. Now before that, what you have to do, this code is available over here, let's see, in the master branch. And then you create a feature branch over here out of it. You can do that in the remote site. And from the feature branch, what exactly you do, you just get an entire clone. So let's see, Naveen is the first guy in this particular project and he's a new joinee. He comes over here and someone has shared this Git URL. So what is my first job? First job is that I have to clone the project. This entire project which is available at the remote site, I have to clone this particular project, so that's why I use Git clone. So I'll clone it somewhere in my laptop, C drive or D drive or anywhere, or in my documents or anywhere in any directory, it doesn't matter. Then whatever the branches that you have created, let's see, master branch or sign up, everything, the full copy of the remote branch or full copy of the remote site, everything will be stored in this particular local repository by using .git folder. Okay guys? Like that. So when you clone it, so this is the .git directory will be created in which you have all the local repositories over there. Then what we have to do, we know that, okay, between this local side and between the working copy, we have a stage and index. Then I'll check out this particular branch and then I'll start working on it. Okay, fine. This is a sign up feature. I'm writing some code and some code is already written over there or something like this. I'm making some changes over here. So when I make some changes, I'll use this particular command git add space dot or a specific file also I can add it to my stage. So stage means available over here. It's a kind of bucket and it maintains the indexing over here. Not in the sequence order, but it will just load all the files in this particular stage. They are maintaining some a queue concept or any specific data structure or algorithm. They are using it to maintain the entire files over here. What kind of algorithm? That's a different topic we can talk about later. It's a very interesting topic. We can talk about how exactly stage maintains all the files over here. Okay. Now that's not the this topic. After stage, what we have to do that, guys, we have to push it to the local repository. Remember one thing, whenever you are making the connection between remote and the local, it means whenever you have to send the file from local to remote, the connection will be happened between these two guys. Okay, you cannot directly push your code from your working copy directly to the remote site, or you cannot directly push your code from stage site to the remote site. You have to move your code to the local site. Now which command you will be using? In that case, you will be using git commit mice and you have to give a reason over here that, okay, hey, what is the reason that, okay, yeah, sign up code is written or, you know, sign up feature is ready or something like this, whatever. So git commit minus n. So it means from this particular commit bucket, you have to move your code to the local repository over here. Now, once a local repository got created, it means that this is my signup. Local repository got created. What I'm going to do, now I'll be pushing my code to the signup feature branch over here. Right? I should not push, or I cannot push from signup to master directly. It is always branch to branch. Right, guys? So I have signup branch over here. I have master branch also available over here. But in my working copy, I have checked out which branch? I have checked out my signup branch. Okay, signup branch over here. It means in my Eclipse, I'm pointing to signup branch only. Okay, guys? So then I'm working on it. I'll move it to the stage index and then I'll commit to my signup branch in my local repository. And then from here, I'll push my code to the signup remote branch, which is available at the remote site on the Git cloud or on the github.com. Okay. And once the code is available over here, what is the final job? The final job is that we have to merge this particular code to the master branch, because the master is the stable branch. The stable code is available over here. So in that case, what I'm going to do, I'm going to merge this particular code with a PR process. PR means the pull request. Okay, guys. So PR means, remember one thing, pull request. So I'm going to merge the code from signup to master. After a proper PR process, I'll raise a PR process or request to my peers, to my lead or to the architect or whatever. And then once it got approved, then I'm gonna merge with the master branch. So this is a typical way of branching. So this is called Git branching concept. Okay, you should do that. Same thing, Naveen is working in his local copy. Let's see some other guy. Let's take an example of some other guy. We have Sachin this time. Okay, Sachin is also doing the same thing. First, this is the working copy. He will clone it. And then first check out the branch to the working copy, then simple do a git add, and then this is the stage or index copy will be maintained over here, and then we will do a commit over here, and commit means the branch is available over here in my local. So this is my local, and then from here we will push the code to add to cart, a second feature, and once this is done, we will merge with PR to the master branch. Same thing for other guy also. We have to do the exactly same thing with third guy. Is this clear? So this is what guys, we have to do that. If you really want to take a screenshot of this, please take it. This is something like a very interesting that you have to explain at a time of interview. Exact same branching concept you have to explain. And you have to explain with working copy to stage, to local copy, to the feature branch, and merging with the master branch. Right, so the workflow is starting from here. First clone, right, this is the clone, and then after that you're doing a checkout. Okay, and then third thing is that you're doing something over here, and then after that git add, and then git commit, and then git push, and then finally after push you have to merge with the PR. That is the last step, sixth step. So these are the six steps that you have to follow. Okay, so remember this thing, you have to, your workflow will start from here and end over here after merging. Fine. So this is the way we have to do that. Now, second thing is that people ask that, okay, hey Naveen, what is the difference between git fetch and git pull? Like, what do you mean by fetch? What do you mean by pull? And what is the best PR process? And what is the merging concept? So these three, fetch and pull. So the concept is fetch versus pull. Most of the people, they get confused between this. What do you mean by git fetch and git pull? So let's see, this is my remote copy. Once again, I'll say that, okay, yeah, this is my remote copy. And this is my local copy. And let's see, this is my working directory. Working directory, where exactly my Eclipse or my editor is available, like that. And this is my remote. This is my local repository. This is my local repository. And this is my remote repository. And this is my working copy. So now guys, what happens whenever you are doing a git pull, I'm talking about git pull. It means you are pulling directly code from remote to the working copy. So this is called pull. Okay, this is called pull. It means you are taking the code directly from the remote repository to the working directory where exactly you're currently you're pointing over here, right? Let's see, this is the master code, and Eclipse also you're pointing to master branch. So we're directly taking the code from here to here. There is no involvement of local repository over here. So this is the local side and this is the remote side, local and remote. Now what is git fetch? So fetch, what exactly it will do? First fetch, we have to do it like this. So first we have to hit this command, git fetch. Fetch means whatever the code is available over here, let's see, from the signup branch, take the code to the local signup branch, okay, to the signup branch, not repo, sorry, this is the branch, okay, on my local, local repository. So I'll take this particular signup to signup over here with the help of fetch. So fetch does not give you the code directly to the Eclipse. It means directly to the working directory. Remember one thing. Pull will fetch the code directly from remote to Eclipse, to the working directory. But fetch will not. Fetch will directly fetch the code from remote repository to the local branch. Okay, over here. Somewhere you're maintaining one dot a git folder, right? But it will not be reflected in your Eclipse or in your editor, whatever you are using. Then second thing, if you really want to take this particular code to this, what do you have to do? Which command you have to do? You have to do merge command. Git merge master. Okay, git merge command, you have to do that. Then what will you do? It means the merge will be merged over here. It means now the code will be visible over here in your working directory. So can I say one thing? If I write, what is git pull? Git pull is equal to what? Git pull is equal to git fetch plus merge. Remember this formula. Git pull is equal to git fetch plus merge. Okay. So git pull means directly over here. This is pull. You're pulling the code directly to the working directory. It will be visible over here. That's why most of the time we do pull. But I don't want to take a direct pull, but I want to maintain in my local repository. So I'll do a fetch first, and whenever it's needed, I'll merge it over here. Okay, so fetch plus merge is equal to pull. Fine? So this is the difference between fetch versus pull. Don't worry, in the next video, guys, I'll tell you practically also all these things. But before that, you have to understand that. Okay, perfect. Now, let me remove this. Now, the next question is, let me remove all these things. Okay. So, now I'm going to tell you guys that what do you mean by PR process, how to raise a PR, how to merge the code, and what are different ways that, okay, you can raise a PR, what are the different situations that you have to face, and make sure that, okay, you are not doing any blunder while merging the code with the master branch. That's very important. So let's talk about it. And this is something very practical thing, guys, that you have to do it, then only you will get the confidence. But first you have to understand the workflow, how exactly the process works, and then only you can work with that. So let's start. Now, let's see. Okay, let's see. This is my team. Okay, and I'm working with the four team members are available. Let's see, this is Naveen, then this is Sachin, then this is Tom, and this is, let's see, some other guy. So I quickly write this name, Naveen. Then we have, let's see, Tom, Sachin, and let's see, Rahul. Or let's see, some other guy, let's see, Lisa. Okay, so these four people are working together on the same project, and Naveen is the team lead. Tom is the, let's see, senior QA guy. And Sachin is, let's see, junior QA. And Lisa is associate QA, let's see. Okay, so Naveen is a team lead, the senior most guy. Now what happens They all are working, having their own eclipse. Perfect. Like this. Now, Naveen, what exactly he does, he creates a folder structure and everything, and he pushed the first code to the master branch over here. So this is my, let's see, this is my repository. Where? This is my remote site on github.com. Okay guys, so this is the remote site and this is the master branch. Let's see, this is my master branch. And first, Naveen has the basic folder structure. Naveen has pushed the code to the master branch, assume that. Okay, so first I have done it. After that, what these guys have to do? First, these guys, they have to take a clone. They have to take the latest clone over here. Clone. Okay, so that's the entire working directory. The working copy will be given to these guys. And they will import this particular project in their Eclipse. And they start working on it. Now, assume that Tom is working on some different, he's a senior QA guy. Let's see, he's working on some different important feature. Let's see, payment feature. Sachin is working on, let's see, sign up feature. And Lisa is working on profile feature, let's see. Or profile automation test cases or whatever, okay. And Naveen is working on some other different feature. Let's see, you can say the search feature. Right? Now, Tom says that, okay, my work is done. The payment work is done. The coding is done. Shall I push my code to the master branch? No. Although this guy is having two branches. One is the payment branch and one is the master branch. So this guy can write the code in master branch and directly push the code to master branch. No, this is a bad practice. Because what is the guarantee that, okay, this guy has written the right code? And you are introducing the buggy code to the master branch. So there is a possibility. Right? So that's what exactly this guy says, that, okay, hey, I'll check out, or I will create another branch, that is the payment branch. I'll check out over here and then I'll start working on this payment branch. And then I'll push my code payment to payment. So I'll create one more branch over here. Let's see, this is my payment branch. This guy will push the code to the payment branch. Okay, so let's see, this is my push to the payment. Now, when we raise a payment branch, then this guy will, okay, Tom will raise a PR. PR means the pull request. Now, this guy will raise a PR to Naveen. This guy will raise a request to Sachin. And this guy will raise a request. Let's see, Lisa also. Let's forget about Lisa. Okay, let's see. These two guys are the approvers. They have to see the PR. So, this is called PR. PR means, as I told you, pull request. Okay, now Sachin says, okay, yeah, this looks good. The code is absolutely good. I don't have any problem with that. So I'll approve it. So let's see, Sachin approved it. But Naveen says, okay, no, where are the test cases? The logic is not good. The conditions are missing over there. Or maybe some issues. So I'll start giving the review comments over here. So I haven't accepted. So I rejected. And then this guy will check, okay, will get a notification that, okay, hey, Naveen is my team lead. And then he has given some review comments, so I have to work upon it, and then I'm gonna work on that particular working comments, and then again I'll push the code over here. So this is my second push. I'll be doing it right. So first time push got rejected. Again I'm going to push the second time, second arrow, you can see that, and again I'll raise a PR to Naveen and Sachin. So this is my second PR request, and again second PR request or updated PR request, and sending it. Sachin again said, okay, no, it's absolutely fine. Naveen says, okay, no, okay, it's fine. Now, this time I'm going to approve it. It looks good. You have modified the code perfectly. Now, the PR request is approved. Right? This PR request is approved, raised by Tom, by Naveen, and this guy, Sachin also. And then we have pushed the code to this guy. After that, what we have to do, we have to merge the code to master. It means whatever the payment feature that we have written in this particular branch, we have to mail it over here. It means we have to merge the code. So this is called merging. Okay. So once the merging is done, the code is available over here. And then inside the master branch, payment branch feature is also available. It means now we can build the project and then deliver to the customer. Okay? Okay. So this is the first scenario. Second scenario is that now Sachin also has written the code. And let's see, Naveen is not available. Naveen is on vacation. And this Tom is also on vacation, not available. And Sachin raised a request to Lisa only that, okay, hey, and I have created, first of all, the master branch. And from the master, I have created another branch, sign up branch. And I'm working on this particular branch. Now I'm going to push the code to the sign up branch only over here. And then I'll raise a request to Lisa that, okay, this is the PR request. I'm going to have it. So from this particular branch, I'm going to raise a request to, this is my PR request to Lisa. Can we do it? Because Lisa is the most junior person or team member in the team, and these two guys are not available. Yeah, that's a valid thing, guys. That's not an issue. You can raise a PR to a junior folks also. It doesn't matter that, okay, you have to raise a request to your team lead or something like that. It's not compulsory. You can define certain rules that, okay, without these two guys' approval, you cannot push the code or you cannot merge the code. But let's see. Lisa is seeing the code and Lisa says, okay, fine, everything looks good. And now we can merge the code over here. So sign up code is also available under master branch now. It means we have merged the code over here as well with sign up. This is the second use case. Now the third use case is that, what? These two guys not available again. And Sachin and Lisa, they are very good friends. Okay, they have really good bonding and they have really good friends. And Lisa is the most junior person and Lisa is working on profile. So she's having the master branch. From here, she will create one profile branch and she will start working on this particular branch. And then this is the profile branch. And then she will push the code over here to the profile branch, right? Now she raised a request, PR request to Sachin, because Naveen and Tom, they both are not available. They both are on vacation. Well, let's say Naveen is on vacation, Tom is busy with some other work and in some other project also he's handling, so he's not available. So he will raise a request, right, for the profile page, and he will raise a PR request to this guy, to Sachin. Now they both are good friends, and Sachin says, okay, fine, I'm not going to check your PR. And guys, okay, that's fine, that okay, I'm going to approve it without seeing the code, without checking the code. I'm going to approve the code. Okay, I'm going to approve your PR. And let's see in this particular profile code that whatever she has written, there are a lot of bugs are there. But just because of this friendship, just because of this connection, okay, this guy has approved the PR. And then this PR repository is having a lot of bugs. So let's see, this is the buggy code. Some bugs are available. And this buggy code got merged over here. It means now your master branch got infected or impacted, and then you are creating a build and deliver it to the customer, to the prod side, to the production through your CI/CD pipeline that you have created, and you are moving to the production. And customer is disappointing now. Why? Because you have introduced the profile bug over here in the production. So that's why customer is raising the complaint, and that's why we are getting the issues heat from the production side. Now you guys tell me and pause the video and comment it, okay, over there in the comment section that, okay, who is the culprit in this case? Sachin is the culprit or Lisa is the culprit, right? Whose responsibility to check it thoroughly? It's both are culprit, but the responsibility with Sachin also. It's not like you are good friends or you have good bonding, it doesn't mean that, okay, you should approve the PR without checking the code or without reviewing the code. This is something very much happens in the industry, in most of the companies, in most of the projects. People having a good friendship and you are my friend, you are my colleague, and then I'm not going to check your PR properly or strictly, and then I'm going to approve it and then it will be merged to the master. And then you have to see the consequences in the production side like that. Or maybe QA team will raise the bugs over here during this side also, right? So either you are getting the bugs from the QA or from the customer. Ultimately, just because of the wrong merge, okay, your master branch got impacted. Then you have to do the revert and everything. Then you will use git revert directly from the master or something like this, that you have to do that. So guys, this is the Git process that you have to follow that. And this is the merging concept that you have to follow. Right? So merge with PR, remember one thing, merge with PR is important. If you're directly merging without pull request, without the review process, make sure, okay, you are doing, either you are very confident about it, then only you should do it, otherwise it's not at all a good practice. Second thing is that, let's say Naveen is working on, okay, a particular feature. He has created this particular master branch, and from master to master, I should not do it. I should always create a separate branch out of it and then do a push to the branch over here and then merge the code over here. That is the best practice for merging and creating the branch out of master branch. Okay, perfect. I know this video is a little lengthy, guys, please, because I have to cover all the things in the one single video. Now, last thing is that I'm going to cover how exactly you have to check out and how exactly you have to create the branch. So let's say this is my master branch. Master flow is happening. This is the flow of the master branch. Okay, so this is my master branch where the stable code is available, right? Let's see, version number 1.0 is going on. Perfect. Now the developers are there. These three developers or your team members, these developers, they have to cut the branch from the master only. Remember one thing. So this guy will come over here and this guy will cut the branch from here and he will start working on it. So what is the branch? Okay, the feature branch. This is called feature branch. So now you got it. What do you mean the feature branch? Feature branch means on which story that you're working on it, on which feature that you're working upon. So if you're working on, let's say, on profile, sign up, login, contacts page, login page, or whatever, the feature, the payment page, add to cart, these are called features. So you have to cut the branch from master and create the feature branch. So feature branch, now at this point of time, what is the difference between master and the feature? They both are exactly same because we have cut it from the master only. So what if the flow is happening in this particular branch, in the master branch, that is the stable branch, the same flow is happening in the feature branch. Now this guy will come over here and this guy will make some changes, right? Some number of files I'm going to add, number of files I'm going to delete or going to update or something like this. After that, after the PR process, I'm going to merge it over here. So my feature, let's see, this is my feature number F1, got merged over here. Right guys? Now from here, I have created version number 2.0. Okay, so this is first, we have to create the feature branch and then merge it with the master branch. And once the branch is available, 2.0 version got upgraded, something like this. Now this guy also coming over here and this guy has two choices. Okay, now let's see, this guy, they have created the branch at the same time from 1.0, or this guy can create the branch from 2.0 also. Because, so for this, what exactly he has to do? First, he has to take up latest pull from here. Now the 2.0 is available over here, right? Latest pull from the master, he can create that. So let's see, he got the master branch over here. And from this particular master branch, he will create the feature branch number F2. And this F2 is already going on like this. And then he will make some changes over here. And then he will push the code. And see, this is the F2 feature. Will push the code to the master with F2 version number 2.1 or something, whatever, right? So this feature is also got merged over here. Like that also you can do that. Now this guy also coming, this guy also take from here, latest pull from here. So that's why we always say that, okay guys, please take the latest pull. And then we have to, he will create a master, he will create one feature branch, F3 branch. F3 branch is already going on over here, working on it, and push the code over here. Now feature F3 is also available. Let's see, version number 3.0. Like that. Now at this point of time, with F3, we have F1, F2, F3 got merged in the master branch. And then from here, through the CI/CD pipeline, I'm going to create a build, that is my jar file or var file I'm going to create. Jar or var, if you're talking about Java. And then I'm going to move it to the QA environment. Then I'm going to move it to the stage environment or something like this. And then I'll move it to the prod environment, like that. If this feature is available, 3.0 will be given to QA environment. They will test it, like that. Okay. And the same thing will be pushed to the prod environment. So this is the thing, guys, that you have to talk about. Cutting the branch from the master branch. So always cut the branch from the master. Okay. And then you have to make some changes and merge it back to the master. This is most ideal way we have to do that. See, there is no compulsion that, okay, you can only cut the branch from master. You can cut the branch from branch to branch also. It means from the feature branch also. Let's see, this is my feature branch F1. And this is my master branch. You can cut the branch F1 branch from the master. And from the F1 again, you can cut the branch F2 branch. So F2 got cut it from where? From F1. F1 got cut from M1. And then you make some changes, you push it over here. I mean, merge it over here with F1, and F1 will merge to the master. Like this also, you can do that. You getting a point? So ultimate target is what? You have to push the code to the master branch, because master branch will be going to the production or will be responsible to create your build over here, and the same stable build will be going to the prod or your Nexus location or whatever. So this is the branching concept. You have to understand that. Okay, so practically also I'll show you guys, don't worry about that, but first you have to understand that this is what you have to do that. Okay, one small thing I'm going to cover. Let's see, these three guys are working, okay, and they are having their own laptop, working copy over here, and this is my remote site. The master branch is available. The first guy, let's see, this is the first guy, has written some code, push the code to the master after the PR process, okay, and push the code to the master, right, on 1st January. Assume that. Now, immediately 2nd January, what exactly this guy will do, that okay, we'll take the latest code from master, latest pull from the master. And now the master branch is available over here. It means master flow is happening over here. And from here, he will cut the branch, the feature branch that this guy is working on. The second guy is working on feature number F2. So he will cut F2 branch from M, from master, and then push the code from F2 to over here, and then merge it to the master. So he has two choices. Either he will directly merge over here in the local. Now the feature F2 is available over here, and then merge the master to master only. Or you create the F2 branch at the remote site. This is the remote site. Sorry. This is the remote site and this is the local site. And then you move this particular branch to F2 branch in the remote site and then merge it over here. That also you can do it. So merging can happen at the local site also, at the remote site also. Remember one thing. So this F2 branch, you have to cut it from master branch and make some changes, merge back to the master, and then master to master push, you can do that. Okay, so this is also you can do that, but I would always prefer you create a branch, F2 branch, and then merge, before merging raise a PR, okay, at the get site. That also you can do that. Now third scenario is that the third guy working on feature F3, and let's see, this is happening on 2nd January is done. Now let's see, 30th January, it means around after 28 days or 29 days, what happens that, okay, this guy says, okay, my feature is ready. But from 2nd January to 30th January, he has not taken any pull. And meanwhile, between these people, they have done a lot of merges over here, a lot of push to the master branch. It means whatever the master branch that this guy initially on 1st January has taken to here, he was working on this particular branch, cut it from the feature F3 branch, And this Mercer branch, we got it actually on 2nd January, let's see. On 1st January, I would say. Right? I would say the 1st January. But from 2nd January to 30th January, these two guys, they have a lot of code they have pushed to the master branch. And this master, let's see, the version is around 10.0 is going on. But this guy is still working on 1.0 master branch. Now you can see the difference. The lot of code is available over here and this guy has not updated the thing. So there are very high chances that whatever other code this guy has written, let's see one login page he has written, and the login page is already available, then you are going to take the latest pull on 30 January. Chances are there that okay, you will start getting conflicts. Because you're working on the same file and someone has already pushed the code to the master with the same file, you're going to take the latest pull now on 30 January. High chances are there, okay, obviously you will get the conflicts over here. Then you have to sit with your team and then you have to resolve the conflicts accordingly. Say that, okay, hey, in this particular code, login page, you have written 10 lines of code, but here in login, we have 100 lines of code is written already. Because these two people, they have already written a lot of things and you have not taken the latest pull from last 28 days. That is also a very bad practice, guys. That's why I always say that, okay, please take the latest pull. Latest pull. Every day you have to keep your master up to date. Your master version is 10.0 and you are still working on master version 1.0. This is totally wrong. From 8.0 or 9.0, it's fine. You're lagging like anything. And your master, this master is ahead of 10 versions. Right, guys? So that's why you have to keep taking the latest pull from the master branch and then cut the branch from the master and then working on it. Okay, so that's why I would like to say this is the end thing, end point over here. Now, I'll show you all these things practically in my next video. So guys, wait for some time. I hope you understood what is Git architecture, Git workflow, and what are different commands are there, what are different conditions or situations and the scenarios are there with respect to Git branching, merging, PR, and pull, push, and checkout, and what do you mean by stage, what do you mean by index, what do you mean by local repository, what do you mean by remote repository, branching, merging, and PR, different situation-based questions are there with respect to a pull request. Okay, people will ask you all these questions. So that time you are not going to write the command over here. Okay, they are not going to give you a laptop. You have to explain the workflow in the form of diagrams like that, in the form of a process, the workflow diagram you have to explain, and you have to make the, you have to connect all the dots like that. And then you have to explain, okay, yeah, this is the PR process I'm showing. You doesn't matter you are really good in automation or some development coding skills and some really good framework or programming you have written. But the problem is, if you don't know the PR process and if you don't know how to push the code properly to the branches and then how to merge the code, that could be a big problem. Okay, guys? And if you don't know and if you're you have the half knowledge about it and you're pushing the code to the wrong branch and wrong code you're going to merge to the master, your master is getting impacted. And then it will be a big blunder you are doing in your company. Remember one thing. Right, guys? Now, if you know the things, you can easily explain at a time of interview. You can justify your experience that, okay, yeah, this is what I have and this is what I have done. It means it clearly shows that, okay, yeah, this guy is knowledgeable. This guy is practically knowledge this guy is having actually. So, guys, please take care of all these things. This is not very a straightforward thing. People should have the knowledge and the experience, okay, how exactly merge and PR and all these things works. Otherwise, you can do a blunder over here. That is what I also have done it, and most of the people, all the developers, all the testers, they have done it. But you will learn eventually, you will learn with the practice. Okay, so thank you so much, guys. Thanks for watching Navin Automation Labs. If you really like this particular video, please comment, like, and subscribe to the channel. And please share with others and let me know if you have any issues. Take care, bye-bye.